Hello friends, my name is Surreal Emil and welcome back to some more Forza Motorsport 2. Today we are continuing on with our Let's Play. This is episode 68 and in today's episode, well, we're going to be using my Ferrari F430 once again because we're going to be heading into, not the regional championships, that's what I was doing last episode, but instead into the factory spec races because we are going to be doing the Ferrari F430 Challenge, a race featuring Ferrari's curvaceous Ferrari F430. The first place prize is an F430 race car, and, well, the competition is a bunch of F430s. Yeah. The tracks, we have the Sebring International Raceway 4, the Silverstone Grand Prix Circuit, the Nürburgring, Mugello, full, and Road Atlanta full. Let's head into the Sebring International Raceway race first. Goddamn Nürburgring, I can never escape this bleeding thing. Hopefully it'll be a bit better in the F430 than it was in the Koenigsegg, though. Because in the Koenigsegg it was a bit harsh, should we say. Should be a lot better in the F430. So are you going to get the rabbit or not? Anyways, just as a quick check. Oh, I do have to change the difficulty back up. Because, of course, if you remember from last episode, I had to do some tomfoolery to get into the last race. Anyways, we have our F430 here. Now, you may notice I have tried to paint this car. I think it looks good. I personally think it looks much better at the back than it does at the front. From the front, it does look a little bit odd. From the back, I actually kind of like it. I was originally going to do like a blue and yellow thing, but I've decided to just go with a sort of blue and blue. I think it's nice personally, but that could just be me. Yeah, I'm not sure. Anyways, of course, one make race for the Ferrari F430. Shouldn't be too difficult a thing, or too difficult a factory spec racing league, this one. The cars are, well, the F430 is a decent enough car. I'm just going to turn the game volume up marginally. There we go. But yeah, the F430 is a pretty okay handling vehicle. It hasn't got too much power. Shouldn't have too many issues driving it, certainly. Some of the tracks could be an issue. Again, the races are long. The Nürburgring race does look like that one could indeed be a bit on the more problematic side, should we say. But hopefully, it shouldn't be too bad. I just had that Ferrari kind of sink into my bumper a bit there. He's a physics-defying Ferrari. Can I have that Ferrari? Yes, of course, as usual, we have the usual suspects in this race. In the previous few races, or sometimes in this series, the race drivers are sort of have their actual, or there's actual racing driver names, I should say. That's what I was trying to get at. You know, like in the JGTC Cup, we have that Eagle, Fighter of the Regal. It's Daniel. Hello, welcome to F430, because that's what I'm driving. In the F430 Challenge. Ooh, God. Anyways, I will try and get my driving better. Anyways, yeah, usual suspects, M. Rossi, Muller. There's Evans back there. Yeah, it's probably going to be Rossi and Muller on top, just because that's sort of the way these races work. They are supposedly the two best drivers in the game. So, yeah, oh, sorry, two of the best drivers. I'm not sure, maybe the real race drivers, especially at like sort of the later stages of the game, maybe the real race drivers are a little bit more difficult competition-wise. I'm not really too sure. To be honest with you, all I really know about the AI is I don't know if any of them are actually more prone to mistakes or not. Maybe they are when you hire them, because you can hire Drivatars to do the races for you. We won't be doing that in this series, of course. Unlike in Gran Turismo 4, where we probably will be doing. But in this game, you can hire the drivers and you can hire all of your opponents. And they demand higher pay cuts and they have things where it's like, oh, they're slightly more aggressive, they're slightly quicker, you know, whatever. And Rossi and Muller are the two most expensive. Again, I'm not sure about the real race car drivers. We'll have a look more into that later on. Why no Almighty Wing? Because this is a factory spec race. I have to keep the car completely and utterly stock. Cannot do anything to this car whatsoever. Apparently this car was bone stock anyway. I'm not sure if I put any... Because I remember, what did I use this for? I used this car in an episode a little bit ago, which is why I'm using it twice. I do like to sort of not use cars twice, but I didn't actually realize the F430 had its own sort of racing series. But I did use the 430 for something a while ago. I'm not quite sure what it was. I don't know if I had to upgrade it or not for that either. But it had no upgrades on it when I first picked it out. Literally all I did before starting this episode was just spend about 10 minutes in the paint shop trying to whip something up. And yeah, this is what I created. Again, what episode is this? This is episode 68. That's what episode this is, and... provided, because I'm actually feeling quite strong today, and, well, considering we haven't done any Forza 2 in a little while, I am planning on doing a couple of episodes today, so, hopefully we'll do this episode and the next episode in this stream, and then we'll also, and then, sort of, next stream. Actually, I don't know. I kind of want to do all three of the remaining series in this stream because once we've done that, that actually means in the next stream I can start doing the professional and endurance races. And what that means is we can start raiding the straw polls. Yes, Daniel, you are correct. The meme number is next. Bear in mind, the meme number's next. I will say one thing about the meme number. Is I am probably going to entirely ignore it that entire episode. That's sort of my plan. just because why not? Well, yeah, it's an episode like any other. To be fair, it's probably going to be the European... I can't remember what they call it in this game. It's like a European Racing Championship. Basically, my plan is... We're going to finish these... I'm going to finish this factory spec race, and then the next episode we are going to we're going to finish off the regional championships, and then in episode 70, we're going to finish off the one make races. And like I said, then we have basically a full run of professional and endurance races to get through. Because that's sort of what's next after this, professional and enduro races, and they should be fun. To be fair, endurance racing in this game is actually pretty fun. Professional racing, I'm not really looking forward to. Because basically what the professional races are is just sort of these races, except they have points. So, there. If that's what's won the straw poll, then that's what I'm using, yes. If it hasn't won the straw poll, then that's not the car being used, so... In case you're wondering, I don't know when to actually end the straw polls off. I might end them off at some point tonight. Oh, actually, yeah, if I finish all the episodes by tonight, if I finish, like, all three of the episodes I want to get finished by tonight, I will, in all likelihood, probably say for the straw polls, right, that's it. The straw polls are over, and I can now... D-Clash straw poll will be over, because hopefully, what I'm planning on doing, again, this is a lot of hopefully stuff, the plan would be, in the case of the Endurance and Professional Series, depending on how long the Professional Series lasts, what I would kind of like to do is, like, do all the D-Class stuff in one stream, all the C-Class stuff in one stream, all the B-Class stuff in one stream. That's sort of me plan. So, yeah. Certain straw polls are... I'll have to take some of those straw polls down anyway, because sort of I've already decided on some cars I'm using. Like, again, I apologise, but yeah, there's certain straw polls where it's like, I'd much rather just use a car of my choosing, personally, but there you go. But don't worry, for all the ones that you have meme suggestions for, I won't do that, i.e., I don't know. I'm assuming D-Class... Talon is winning. I think I looked at the C-Class thing. I'm going to have to part with a lot of money because it's a 250 GTO. The hilarious thing is the reason I put the 250 GTO on there is if it was like Forza 3, the Eagle is winning. How many votes has the Eagle got, just out of curiosity? But yeah, if it was to... What was I saying? Yeah, people, if it was Forza 3 or Forza 4, then the 250 GTO wouldn't be on there. I think what people are forgetting is, they're like, oh hey, 250 GTO, let's vote for that and he'll have no money. And it's like, yeah, but the 250 GTO has, like, no... It costs nothing in this game. It costs 162,000 credits. A Porsche 911 GT3 costs more, I think, so... Yeah, it's not, you know... It isn't quite as bad as you would think. Anyways... I will say this Ferrari's a lot slower than you'd probably expect to be. It's got 6 votes, and I assume the Familia is on 4? I think the last time I checked, the Familia is on 4, so yeah. Right. There we go. Actually, I should... Do I make a video about the straw... I don't know. I might make a video about the straw polls at some point tomorrow and... Yeah, I don't know. Get more attention brewing on them. But we'll have to see. I don't know. It's on 4. Okay. So, Familia... Because the Familia and the Talon were tied for a little while, so I was kind of curious about that, but thank you. Yeah, I guess it is the meme is going to be the car used for the D-Class World Championships. What are you bringing into the D-Class World Championships? Well, I'm bringing in a car which isn't made anymore. Even the Eclipse isn't actually built anymore, come to think of it. That's kind of sad. I like the Mitsubishi Eclipse. That's a cool car. That's why I used it for the... was it the video that went up today? It was like Eclipse versus... Celica or something, I think. I think I did try for that, Daniel. I'm fairly certain I did try and use the Talon for that. I can't remember. I don't think I could. I think it was in the stream when I did it, so... Yeah. So, yeah, I guess finally the car will show up. What did I put it for, by the way? It is World Championships, isn't it? It's not for the Enduro. I think the Enduro's 2000 GT, I think people voted for, which is a bit of a shame. I kind of wanted to use the Acura because four-wheel drive, but it's the best car, Kappa. I mean, it's not. I personally prefer the Familia. I really like the Mazda Speed Familia, apparently, but I guess I'll have to wait until another... game where I can use that. I'm fairly certain it's in Gran Turismo 4, actually, which is probably the next big... Oh, I don't want to actually say that, just in case it isn't, but it might very well be. I don't know. I kind of want to cover Forza 5 at some point, believe it or not, just because I kind of like Forza 5, as much as I know people hate it. I like Forza 5. I don't know. I don't really want to cover any other... No. I don't know, I think Rhino was on about Underground yesterday, and... So, I don't know. I could very well do Underground. I'll probably do Underground again at some point. It's for the D-Class World Championships. Okay, I was right then. Anyways, a pretty uneventful race there, but we are across the line. That is 56,893 credits. Finally gets us to level 45. And, yeah, we get a 98 R390 GT1. I will certainly take that. We also get a 20% discount on tyre compounds made by Bridgestone, which could be useful. I can't remember if Bridgestone's one of the lesser brands when it comes to tyres in this game, though. Anyways. Yeah, there we go. That's our R390. Interesting fact about this one. It's the wrong R390. This should actually be a long tail, but it's not. Which is kind of interesting. I still would have preferred the 97. I personally prefer the 97 livery, but there you go. Anyways, next race heads to the Silverstone Grand Prix circuit. Do an underground stream. Yeah, that's probably going to be the next stream after... I'm saying this after we finish Forza 2. Forza 2's, believe it or not, we're still really not done with this game yet. There is still quite a lot more to do. The pleasing thing, though, is, of course, considering this is 68, there is officially 22 more... Oh, sorry, 21 and a half, technically, if you count to this point. But, yeah, there's... After this episode, there is 21 or 22... Am I being dumb? I think I'm being dumb. Yeah, technically, there's 21 more episodes to go after this. Also, the textures have slightly glitched out in the exhaust pipes. Ignore that. I don't know why that happens. Apparently, pieces of black on this game kind of occasionally get confused and turn blue. I don't know if that's just because I've got the game installed to the 360 hard drive or something, but... Yeah, that's something a little bit weird that happens. You just have to sort of ignore it for a bit. Yeah, Underground's cool. The only thing I don't like about Underground is the fact I've done the... I want a new TXR game. Well, they've... I'm not sure if they've announced something or not. Some game I've been running first and second in practice is looking good. Excellent, well done. Also, hello, Happy. Yeah, to be honest with you, buddy, the Clio Cup actually sounds like something I'd actually kind of enjoy, but I was just, like, about to stream, so I was like, sorry. Race 1 is about to start, nice. But yeah, it's something I would have kind of liked to join, but I just decided I was going to stream anyways, and I kind of want to get the final sort of free... I want to do the final... I've been just saying it for the entirety of this bit that you haven't seen. Essentially, I kind of want to beat all three of the remaining races that aren't Professional League races today. So that would be the F430 Challenge, the Pan... I think it's like European Championship or something, which is for super fast cars, and also the McLaren F1 Challenge. So yeah, that's episode 68, 69, and 70 that I want to get in the bag today. It's 68. It's a 7-week championship, first race around the grid, second race reverse grid. Nice. So which Clio is it, just out of curiosity? Because I remember driving, if it's the 2010, I remember driving that thing. That thing definitely needs a differential in it to be strong. 7 different tracks. Cool. Is it an actual, like, official thing, or is it just the friendo thing? To be honest with you, that would be something I'd kind of like to set up if I grew the channel a bit more. Maybe have a... Or actually, it could even be the Williams. Yeah, the meme part is next. But yeah, I don't know. I would kind of like to set up like a channel championship or something. I really like that thing Fail Race did in Forza 5 when they had the Fail Race Touring Car Championship. I'd kind of like to do something like that for the channel. I guess it needs to sort of grow a bit more. But, I mean, that's definitely something I would be interested in running in the future. It'd be kind of cool, I guess. Just have to make sure everyone who joins has good internet. But yeah, I can see myself doing something like that. I'll probably have like 10 competitors or something. Maybe do like a Focus ST Cup or something. That's one of my favourite cars in Forza 6, so... Yeah, that would be kind of neat to maybe set up one day. We'll have to see, though. Anyways. Who can be the dankest meme? Well, I mean, everyone knows the dankest meme of all is Rhino, because, of course, he coined the phrase, pink fucking vits, which is known and loved throughout the world. Thunder can also be a bit of a meme. Q's a fucking... Yeah, Q can be... Q's probably... I don't know. Q's the most consistently dank. Rhino's the ultimate dank, if that makes any sense. I guess. I don't know. I just noticed there's also the Ferrari logo, which I put on top of the roof, which you can't see. Unless I change camera angle, maybe. Nope. My internet is terrible. I can imagine. Don't worry about it too much. Pink Vits. Yes. Oh, yeah. That's a point. Gran Turismo 3 as well. I do actually have GT3. I'm so terrible at deciding between GT3 and 4. Like, here's my issue. I want to cover Gran Turismo 4 because, you know, I like Gran Turismo 4 a lot. It's my personal favourite between the two. You're a forced meme. I mean, yeah. You can do some cool stuff every now and again. I mean, admittedly, you kind of killed the Mac joke, but that was funny before. Eagle Talon occasionally tickles my insides as well. Not all the time, but sometimes, when it's actually appropriate, i.e. Actually, is that a point? Daniel, can we do GT3? But I like GT4 better. Either way, it's going to be live-streamed, so you'll get to enjoy that with me. But yeah, GT4 seems the more appealing to me, because also that, technically, if I do GT4, I can be the second person to ever officially do a GT4 LP 100%, because I would be 100% in GT4. And that would include 24-hour races and all the rest of it. Again, I don't know. I'm just trying to actually think in terms of getting Forza 2 finished, because here's a slight thing. Actually, nah, I'm not going to discuss that, but I don't know. Let's just say Streamy Happy Time might be happening a bit more often later on next month, but we'll have to see. Yeah, GT4 would probably be my more preferred of the two, but GT3 probably. My meme shall be! Yeah, Rhino did it first. Emil. But I'm not a meme. I don't say memey things. I say stupid things occasionally. I don't say memey things, really. I don't class myself as too big of a meme. Eh. I don't know. When I'm on Discord, I'm a bit of a meme because, yeah. Also, it's funny to change the people in our Discord chat's names. Which, Happy, if you can actually get anywhere near a computer, that might be a cool thing for you to check out. Because, honestly, it is quite amusing. I changed Pro Racing's name a lot, make him very angry. I can't remember what I... What did I... E-me-meal? Nice. Anyways. What did I change it to the other day, and it did crack me up a bit. It's just like, I dream about a 320i, or something like that, because, yeah, I like to make fun of the fact he's bought a silly diesel. Because I find stuff like that kind of amusing. Anyways. We are on lap 4 of 6. Okay, cool. So, this racing's actually going pretty well, not gonna lie. Like I said, though, the Nürburgring is in here. The Nürburgring is where my world... Or the Nürburgring? The Nürburgring could be very much where my luck turns upside down. I've got my new PC. I will be on Discord soon. Oh, God. Pro Racist has bad memes. I haven't even checked. How's Thanks is his memes? That's awesome for me. That sounds like a pretty decent PC. I mean... Oh, it's got an i5 in it? I read that as an i3, I apologise. That's actually pretty decent. You could probably run my Elgato software with that, because the Elgato requires you to have like an i5 and some other stuff. Skoda fan is cool. Skodas are cool. I like Skodas. Yeah, I mean, I've always kind of liked Skodas. I like the... probably one of my favourite Skodas, interestingly enough, was the Felicia. Was it the Felicia? Something like that. The, Rally 1. I think it was in Colin McRae, Rally 1. That was a pretty cool car. I've tried playing Colin McRae Rally 1 recently, by the way. I'm terrible at that game. I'm terrible at all rallying games. I can't play it. Please emphasize on... Oh. No. No. Not happening. Eagle never had a rally car. He probably had a rally trim level, because that was a thing at one point. The Chevrolet Chevette has a rally trim for no apparent reason. Also, in case you're wondering, yes, I have been binging on regular car reviews today. Because, I don't know, I go on kinks with regular car reviews. Once a week, I will basically go back and watch quite a few old episodes. So, yeah. Skoda Fan was pro's name once. Nice. I got V-Rally. I've heard V-Rally is good. I think I had that for like the PS2 back in the day, but I think I sold it and played it once. I don't really remember it. Dual Core Peasant Machine. Nice. From 2006, we'll run my Hopag off software. Yeah, the Elgato is weird. I'm bad. It's difficult to drive. Yeah. So I really want to get the console version of Dirt Rally, just because I think if I end up playing it on a console, I'll do a bit better than I do on PC right now. Because I'm terrible at Dirt Rally. I really am. Mind you, I'm terrible at Forza Horizon Rally, so... make of that what you will. Anyways, coming on to the final lap now. The other car's 2 seconds behind. I could be taking these laps a little bit quicker. But honestly, if the AI isn't really going to pressure me, why should I really push myself all that much? You know, I'll only get into an accident or something. I'm just sort of chilling right now. I'm chilling. It's fine. Everything's going dandy. It's going dandelion and burdocked. Yes. That's not what I'm drinking right now. I have cherry Coke because Coke was on offer today and I decided to get some, so... Yeah. Not usually a fan of Coca-Cola, but cherry Coca-Cola is quite nice. Personally, if you're gonna ask me, Coca-Cola over Pepsi. Pepsi over Coca-Cola. I personally prefer Pepsi. It's got a bit of a more subdued taste to it, isn't it? Use the walls to break. I mean, that's not a good idea, especially considering damages on simulation, I think. Dirt free, I'm decent at. Dirt free, I can be decent at dirt free. For me in rally games, it really depends on the stage. Like, I was on Dirt Rally the other day. I think I played for the Sweden stage. I was good at the Sweden stage. I think it's like Australia or something. I'm not particularly good at because too much bumps and stuff. I have too much cola. So do I, but I really don't care about my well-being, so that's fine. Cherry Coke is terrible. I like it. I don't know. I like stuff with cherry in it. It tastes quite nice. Vanilla is not nice because Ibiza and bought loads of Coke. Are you still in Ibiza? When are you coming back to the UK? Yeah, it is the UK for you, isn't it? I just thought about that for a second. Nope, Wales is definitely part of the UK. I am being dumb. Anyways. M. Rossi is just a bit too far behind to really make a move on me. I did have some issues coming out of that corner then. I mean, how far is he behind? 2 seconds. Not too bad. Eh, Coke. Yes. Anyways, there we go. Cross the line in the F430. And yeah, 57,215 credits. We get to level 5 with the car, which means we've reached max level. We get a 10% discount on cams and valves and engine block upgrades by Ferrari. Which obviously you can only use on Ferraris, unless Fiat has decided to bring in Ferrari as the main tuner. I don't know. Anyways, next race heads to the Nürburgring. I'm gonna have to flick over to the page of the takes because potentially could be a few takes on this one. Right. Here we go. First try. Let's see if we can pull this one off. Hopefully we can. Oh yeah, I painted the brake discs blue as well. I actually painted the entire car blue, as you can probably tell, because, yeah, it was white before. I think I had a white one before, but this one's blue, so, yeah, I've changed the colour, as well as put all the decals on it and stuff. I actually really like this blue on blue. I really sort of like this as a colour scheme. It's sort of a colour scheme that I used on Forza 4 a lot. I tried to have like a Fail Race inspired paint job. I think for Forza 5, Horizon 2, and I don't use it in Forza 6, I had like a purple and black and white stripe approach. You actually see it in one of the old Forza 5 videos. I can't remember which one it is though. But yeah, that's what I use in that video. But for some of Forza 4, I actually ran a blue car with sort of like a blue tire tread on it. It's very much inspired by the Gran Turismo 6 Special Edition cars, because I really like the way those things look. Oh god, is Daniel being kidnapped by ISIS? Like Marina Joyce, huh, that's going to be an old joke by the time this video comes out. It's not really a joke though, is it? But still, paint it orange with black stripes, but I've already painted it. I mean, I can... Here's an idea actually, Daniel. If the Talon wins the vote, you can pick how I paint the Talon. How about that? Because, yeah, why not? Anyways. Yeah, you can pick how the Talon will look once I've painted it. I don't know. Anyways, no real issues so far. I did go off the track a little bit earlier, but that's to be expected. I'm 2 seconds in front of the car behind, so... Yeah, again, hopefully... This car's a bit more stable than the Koenigsegg that I drove around last time was. Hopefully... Should I go off the track in this car, I should paint it again. I don't want to paint it again. I said you can paint the... You can choose how we paint the Talon. How about that? Also, I'm assuming you'll probably want body mods and almighty wing on it, so, yeah. Pink. Oh, Jesus. Pink Talon. Oh, boy. Okay. If I go for a pink Talon, though, bear in mind, I'll probably do, like, a design similar to this Ferrari on it. I might two-tone it, make it, like, pink and black or something, I don't know. Just so it looks a bit more appealing to people, I don't know. I'll have to figure it out once I get eyes on the Talon. I'm sure I could do some meme things to the talent. I don't with purple stripes. Oh god. Oh god. I tell you what, if we make it to the and a big wing, of course. If I can make it to the end of this stream, having done what I needed to do, should we? Actually, I don't know if you'll be up long enough for it, but yeah, if you're still on by the time, we'll actually paint it on stream for you now, so you can wait until next stream when it shows up. How about that? I think that's something, yeah. Anyways, well, I'll paint the talent for you anyway, even if it doesn't win the straw poll. Which, you know, there's still time. Someone, please, God, vote for the Master Familia. I'll pay you. I will pay you in shout-out. No, I won't. Don't do shout-outs. We've discussed this. Anyways. I don't do many things on this channel, actually, surprisingly enough. I don't do the whole self-promotion thing either, even though my channel... that's all what my blacklist is there for. In case you're wondering why my blacklist picks up words like subs and subscribe, that's kind of why. I think I didn't... A rice and body kit, clearly. Actually, there is... I'm fairly certain there's body options for Talon in this game. I know there is in the future Forza game, so surely there must be in this game. Somewhere buried in there, there'll be body options for that car. Oh hey, Muller is leading Rossi. I guess this is sort of Muller's home turf. It's Germany, but still. Ugly wheels. Oh yeah, that's actually a point. I don't think I've... Oh wait, no, I put wheels on the Civic, didn't I? Might have done on the Lexus as well. I don't really remember. Those episodes have actually gone up if you want to have a look at those and sort of check if I put wheels on the car or not. I'm not sure if I did. Speaking of which, I do actually need to go on an upload spree. I'll probably go on an upload spree tomorrow. I don't know. Maybe Sunday or tomorrow or something. I don't know. I'll go on a big upload spree. And we'll, yeah, because I need to get some of those extra videos up because currently it stands at me doing... I think there's... I've got until episode 40. If I can get make it a jelly... No, I'm not doing anything special with the tuning. I'll do some special stuff to the aesthetics because they don't really matter. I'm not making it a jelly car or anything. I need this thing to actually be drivable for the professional series because, you know, it's the professional series. So yeah, you can handle the aesthetics. I'll handle how the thing actually drives because it's me driving it. So yeah. Anyways, Ferrari, had to leave because of broken adapters. Oh, that's fine, don't worry. You haven't missed much. I've just, I might have done a bad thing and said that if the Eagle Talon wins the straw polls, then Daniel has free reign to paint the damn thing. And also do anything aesthetically. He wants me to make, I made the best Talon for you. Oh, Christ. Why do I have to have talons made for me? The wheels need to be green. Oh, Jesus. Oh, God. I feel sorry for anyone who happens to either A, watch that episode on YouTube, or B, like, catch the stream live. Like, just come into it like, oh, hey, I see you doing Forza 2. I really liked Forza 2 as a kid. What the fuck is that? Yeah, that's going to be fun to explain to people. Anyways. Kind of glad I've got chat with me now because it's sort of, I'm focusing on the chat more than my innate fear of the Nürburgring because I really hate this place. I'm actually kind of scared about driving around this place. It just seems like such a strange track. Here's the thing, I hate the Nürburgring in games. I'd still like to go in real life though because it's a publicly available track and I'm fairly certain there's no speed limits on it anymore because they sort of... And a sticker saying I like TXR. Okay, you're pushing it too far now, buddy. I ain't putting that fucking thing on the back of it. Maybe I'll put... I made a white and black stripes talon for Daniel. Oh yeah, of course, because white and black. Yeah. Anyways. Right. Anyways, I'm conquering the Nürburgring. I picked up a decent distance on people back through that corner. I've actually started making some time. Another saying, weeb trash. Oh god, Boomex body kit. Oh, is that the body kit available? Is that the silly body kit available for it? I know there's a silly body kit for the Talon. I didn't know if it was a Boomex one or not. Anyways, I just completed my first lap of the Nürburgring without too many issues. Sure, my time is slow as hell. Dub wheels, positive camera, oh, jelly tune, oh god. Anyways, are we near the finish line? It's gonna be like an 8:30 something, but still. It's not too bad in a straight line, 180, that's more than I was expecting. An 8 minutes 32 seconds, 0.518. Yeah, that's actually kind of long. But still. I got it round there. Can I get to 190? Not quite. I didn't really have to start braking there, but I do have to start braking here really quite suddenly. Just gonna... So anyone can drive like Daniel, clearly. Oh man, there we go. Right. First lap went off with our hitch. Hopefully... Boomex made the bad body kits. Hey! Anyways. Hopefully... I don't want to jinx myself here. I really don't, but at the same time... I sort of have a hope that I can do the second lap relatively right. I like how the Nürburgring GP circuit's in the background there, but they didn't actually use the GP circuit till Forza 4? Was the GP circuit in 3? I don't ever remember the GP circuit being in... Forza 3. Interesting. But yeah, it's in the background though, which is kind of odd, but there you go. First production car to beat the 8-minute mark. What, the F430 was? That's kind of neat if that's true. I'm not sure if it was. I'd stick to saying it was Emil's idea. Oh god. No. You're actually physically making me ill right now. The words you're saying, R33 V-Spec. Oh, the R33 V-Spec was? Eh? That's kind of cool, I guess. I don't know, that's such a weird car to win it. I do actually find, if you actually... Oh, shit. Okay, we're not completely... Ooh, that was a scary moment right there. Ooh. I'm gonna need a new... Yeah, that was... Wow. I've got bad internet. Yeah, I apologise. It did a 7.59. That's interesting, actually. If you do look into Nürburgring lap times, they're kind of strange. Like, in real life, the Lamborghini Gallardo set a 7.41. Messages are out of order sometimes. I think that just happens. I think that's just a YouTube thing. I'm not sure if that's on your end. But the Lamborghini Gallardo Superleggera set a 7.41, which is the same time as a Chevrolet Camaro ZL1, which... I mean, I don't want to dump on the Camaro too much because the ZL1 is actually a cool car, but it just seems like such a strange, because like, you got to remember, the ZL1 has less power, I think. Actually, it might have more power. Yeah, it probably does have more power. Also, by the way, I'm not sure what model Superleggera it is. I'm not sure if it's the LP570 or if it's the older one. They weren't too far apart in terms of power, though. But yeah, it's just... Ouch. Right. That was kind of my own fault there. What actually happened is I went to turn the corner. I'm making the best corner. It will be amazing. Oh, God. I went to turn a corner and my thumb slipped off of the thumbstick and sort of went to the side. I don't think... I've never had that issue before. I don't know what was up there, but yeah, my thumb actually kind of slipped off the controller, so that wasn't the best, but there you go. So yeah, not an exactly clean lap of the Nürburgring, but so far, so okay. I guess it's fine. The good news is that we're level 45 now. And being level 45 doesn't guarantee me one great thing, and that's that I don't actually have to level up anymore. There's only... Can't wait for that stream. Oh, God. Yeah, that'll probably be the next stream after this one. But the good thing with being level 45 is that I've locked... It means I've unlocked all of the race series bar for one. There's one race series which I haven't unlocked yet, and that's the... one race which I haven't unlocked yet, which is the final race in the game. I may have also... There may also be something locked in the professional series, but basically what that means is there's one last race to get in the professional series, one last in the endurance races. We shouldn't be getting to those until episode 89 and 90 respectively, so by that time I should be well past level 50. So yeah, I don't actually have to worry about level caps anymore, which is kind of nice. I mean, I guess I do for some cars, but I shouldn't really need any car that's locked at particularly the level. I think I unlocked the McLaren F1 in the last episode. This stream is JDM as fuck. But I'm driving an Italian car. And I've been speaking about a German... on a German racetrack. Against... I think there's like one Japanese opponent in this race. I don't know. Just Daniel memes. Okay. Let's try and get through there. Okay. We're moving on to the more unknown part of this track. It's such a... It is a weird sort of place to be in this part of the track. I did a... license test on Gran Turismo 4, and I had some huge issues with this part of the track. So I'm basically at a point now where I know where I am as soon as I turn a corner and look at the curb. I know that sounds kind of strange, but yeah, so I don't know where I am. Why are you playing Forza Horizon? What, me? Why was I playing Forza Horizon, or why? What? I'm confused. You've confused me. I was playing Forza Horizon a couple of weeks ago because I was going to start... looked at game played under video. It shouldn't be Forza Horizon. It should not be Horizon. I swear I said it to Forza Motorsport 2, but if it's Horizon, then that's may not show on... mobile! Potentially. I don't know. It shouldn't be doing that, though. If it is doing that. Go around here. There we go. Again, I'm sure people who are fast around this track are probably cringing right now, but I'm scared to death of this track, so. Came in second place. That's... Well done. How many people are competing happy, if you don't mind me asking? But yeah, that's great. Game played on YouTube is Forza Horizon. I will check that in a second. It shouldn't be saying that, though, if it is. Because I swear I said it to Forza Motorsport 2. Admittedly, I could have misclicked and clicked Horizon by accident, but... Mind you, I think this whole, you know, YouTube showing the game you're playing doesn't work particularly well anyway, so... I don't know. I'll check it in a second, though, because... We are almost done, and the only really not cosmetic bit of damage that happened was I believe I injured the brake slightly, so. The Nordschleife on the Forza 2 looks brilliant. It does look pretty pretty, actually. I think they got the, sort of the lighting and everything correct, and sort of the time of day right on this track in this game. If I was driving, it would have been roll first in race 2. Emil is going to do a Forza Horizon Let's Play, so FNOL doesn't get any views. I've already done a Forza Horizon Let's Play. Anyways. Nope, according to this, the game is Forza Motorsport 2. Anyways. 52,954 credits despite the damage. We don't level up the car anymore because the car can't be leveled up anymore. And we don't level up anymore because we leveled up to level 45 in the last race, I think. Anyways, next race heads to an admittedly less scary track, the Mugello Full Circuit, for 6 laps, I believe, so get buckled in for that. I should have really cut out these loading screens, but there. I do on some games. I think I did for Gran Turismo 2. If I'm not streaming, I usually cut the loading screens out, but the loading screens are sort of when I'm streaming, it's sort of where I answer some questions and say some stuff. Yeah. Ooh, there we go. When you get Xbox Live, I'm getting, even though I'm not running it. Are you talking to Ethanol? Ethanol has 10 subs. He had 12 last time I checked. I don't know. Don't ask me why. Well, Emil can join it, as I know he's clean. I mean, it does look... It could be something I'd potentially join. Again, in one episode, he talks about school. Oh, God, don't remind me of that fucking episode. Oh, God, that episode is cringy as fuck. Well, it's not that bad. I don't give away too much of my thing, but still. Forza Horizon's a game I really need to go back through again. No, Daniel, it's on Forza 6. Fair enough. But yeah, Forza Horizon Let's Play is something I should probably redo. Funda actually asked me an interesting question the other day. He was just saying, like, because he was on about Most Wanted, and I was saying how much I hated that game when I LP'd it. And he was saying something about redoing LPs, and I actually came... I was looking at the sort of games I've LP'd, and sort of wondering, you know, which ones would I redo? And I came to the conclusion of all of them except for Most Wanted. Because he said something about ever redoing Most Wanted, and I was kind of thinking about it today, but at the same time it's like, oh no, I don't think I could do that to myself again. It was so... I hated Most Wanted. Again, honestly, it's such a strange thing. I absolutely despise Need for Speed Most Wanted now. It's one of my favourite games growing up, but now it's just... I hate that game so goddamn much because that LP. I despise it. Anyways. You hated it because you suck, Carver. I thought about if I get a back mic, I redo them. I don't know. I think my presenting style... I don't really know, because my sort of presentation hasn't... Like, nothing's really changed all that much since that Horizon Let's Play. The only thing that's changed is I've moved from the room over there to the room here. That's it. Like, all my recording equipment is the same. Actually, no, I got a new capture card, but technically it's the same because it's just a... It's just an Elgato, but it's not the HD60 or HG60? Wow, I'm too used to saying that. HD60, which I used to use. I use just the standard Elgato game capture now because that can capture PlayStation 3, which is kind of useful. It's alright. By now, race to time. Okay, fair enough. Tell me how you get on, buddy. But yeah. Yeah, I didn't like Most Wanted. It just... like I said, it's a good game, but I personally much prefer Carbon. I think Carbon's much better paced than all the rest of it. I don't know. Carbon's such a weird game. Like, I wouldn't redo my LP of it, because my LP of Carbon, in my opinion, that is still by far and away my favourite LP. Like, I just love my LP. It sounds so strange, but I actually really do like my LP of Carbon a lot more than most of them. Usually I hate my old LPs, but Carbon, I like Carbon a lot. I think the cars handle too easily, kind of. I don't think there was any issue with the handling for me, per se, but I just didn't like the AI, because the AI was bollocks. The catch up on them was insane. The funny thing is, I think we were arguing about it over a TXR stream, I don't remember. But either way, I don't know, ask the blacklist, but the Most Wanted, we was actually going through it, and you know, I said, oh, the catch-up's bullshit, and it was just like, oh, what are you on about, come on, catch-up's fine. So I linked them out on Discord. Hey, Emil, I can talk to you without using Discord. Hey! Yeah, I mean, you could. I wouldn't recommend it, because everything gets read out publicly anyway, but yeah. Provided it's not a silly thing. So... Yeah. It's, What was I saying? Yeah. So he's on about Most Wanted, and I was like, oh, you're talking, yeah, and I linked him to episode, it was Blacklist number 3, Ronnie. Okay, and basically on this race, Ronnie would crash in some metal pylons, and he would do that without fail each and every lap and fall about 4,000 feet behind, but by the end of the lap, he would be right up with me. You know, he would be, Daniel is a chav, I know, but yeah, he would be right up behind me again. And at some point in the lap, it literally looked like he's teleported. So Q was just like, I don't know what you're on about. So Q ended up checking out the video. And by the end of it, Q like literally said, like, yeah, there is something bad happening here. Like, it genuinely looked like some form of teleportation was happening. Like, and I'm not making that up either. It's just, it was ridiculous to catch up in Most Wanted. So, yeah. Basically, everyone who's watched, everyone in this chat is sub to me. Are they? Eh, maybe. I don't know. Anyways. So, yeah, that's just why I don't like Most Wanted anymore. The problem with Most Wanted is I can't really play it for fun anymore. I still want to play through the Black Edition of the game at some point, because that comes with some cool stuff. And I'd like to do Challenge 69, because Challenge 69 is a hell of a lot of fun as well. Excuse me. But just, I can't play through Most Wanted. I don't like it anymore. I'm sorry, I just don't like the game anymore. As far as Need for Speed games go, of course, it's no way high on my list either. Of course, Underground is probably the next game that I'm going to have to attempt again for the, like, 4th or 5th or 6th time. I lost count at this point. But yeah, I need to cover fucking Underground 1 again. It was blacklisted. Yeah, it was blacklisted. Underground's probably the next Need for Speed. Not sure after that. I kind of want to redo Underground 2. Who at some point. I'm not in a rush to do that, because I think the Underground Let's Play is okay. The issue the Underground Let's Play had is it, like, got, if you actually, like, look at you can see what's blacklisted. Can you see what's blacklisted now, or you can see what's blacklisted sort of when it pops up, F and all. I'm kind of curious. Anyways. Yeah, the one thing with Underground 2 is the issue it had was it sort of got cancelled and rebought up and cancelled and rebought up over and over again. Like, if you look at the time frames to my old LPs, you can see some issue. Like, I think Horizon lasted for 4 months, and it was a 25-episode LP, to put that in perspective. Underground 2 was, I think Underground 2 was, like, July to February 2016, so, last year I must have started Underground 2. Jesus. Not much has changed since then. Same microphone, same controllers and everything. I've just gotten a little bit more, I guess you could say, confident in my delivery. I think the Underground 2 stuff wasn't too bad. I do have to admit, if you go back to some of my old Forza Top Gear laps, I do have to admit, I do sound a little bit sort of, I don't sound as lively as I did before. And it's kind of strange, because I actually look at those videos and I can see what someone says when someone says something blacklisted. I get you. Okay. So you can see, even when Daniel says something blacklisted, actually no, because you've banned some self-promoters we've had before, haven't you? I do remember that. But yeah, I mean, it's strange, because some of those videos really aren't all that old, and my delivery wasn't great in them, but hopefully I'm a bit more sort of confident in my approach now. I know how to do a Let's Play. Let's Plays are easy. The one thing I will say, I don't know, streaming the LPs, it's such a weird thing. I think for something like this, it works well. I think for the shorter games, I'm probably not going to, mind you. I don't know, it's such a double-edged sword. Like, I like streaming the LPs, but the issue is sometimes I get a bit too reliant on chat, so that when sort of the chat isn't really there, my presenting quality falls, and, you know, I used to be able to really think on my toes, and that's something I can't do quite as well anymore, but nevertheless, I still think it's a good idea to sort of have the stream open. You know, I think the people like it as well because, you know, I've improved quite a lot since my first video on the channel. I really, really have someday. You will never be a mod. You really will never, ever, ever, ever touch my mod stick. There you go. Ethanol, I think Daniel here needs a bit of a ban. Yeah, I think you need to throw the ban hammer in his direction and just point it at him. Just point it at him. Yeah, that's all I'm saying. I'm not saying you can use it. That's actually one thing. People have asked me before, like, oh, can I ban this certain person? And it's like, you do whatever. You're your own person. I don't care. You do whatever you want to do. I'm not saying I won't unban them afterwards, but yeah. Mind you, Daniel, we need you for comic relief, actually, occasionally. My old channel's awful. I didn't actually have a channel before this channel. This has been my first and only YouTube... Well, it's not my only YouTube channel because, well, there's quite a lot of them, but ban. Okay. But yeah. You know, this is the only channel I've ever had, so... Yeah, it's not too... It's not too bad. Anyways, we are on lap 6 of 6. Muller is... they're a corner behind. They're pretty close in this racing, you know. I'm not going to lie. It's sort of... I'm at a point where it's like they could... I would time out, but that would kill chat. Yeah, wait until Happy's back and then you can get rid of him. Kappa. Anyways. But yeah. What was I saying? I was saying words. There's sort of a corner behind me, like, they can pounce if I make a mistake. Luckily, I haven't really made too many mistakes. I did on the Nürburgring, but other than that, it's been pretty rock solid. Anyways, I'll try and adjust myself in my chair now, because it's a bit of an odd angle. I don't know. Ooh, there we go. 57,536 credits, move the pop filter slightly. Yeah, there's nothing to really say other than that because, well, we don't unlock a car and we don't level up or anything like that, so, yeah. And our final race for today heads to Road Atlanta. I have another account just for subscribing and watching stuff. This is my interacting account. I try and leave everything all in one place because I can't go through the hassle of unsubscribe. Oh, sorry, from signing out and signing in and signing out and signing in. In case you're actually curious, on my other few channels that I have, usually, like with the TRE playthroughs, what I have, I'm loyal. Yeah, basically. Or just a team with nothing better to do. Eh, I mean, there's that, but both of which benefit me, so I don't care. Anyways. What was I saying? Oh, yeah. On the second channel, TRE Playthroughs, I'm just subscribed to the stuff which I am sort of... I subscribe to my essential stuff, basically, just in case this channel was to ever go down for whatever reason. I'm subscribed... What am I subscribed to on that channel? I think I'm subscribed to, like, Fail Race, Thunder, Rhino, a COD channel, which I kind of used to like. I'm not so hot on them anymore. I've some outs as well. I don't remember. But, yeah, I'm subscribed to a few things. It takes just a click of a button. Yeah, but, I mean, with Google, you have to sort of sign in and sign out. I don't really like it. My sort of strategy when it comes to running multiple channels, though, is to just have one logged into each browser. So, my main channel is sort of controlled by Chrome, because Chrome is my preferred browser. But NerdCubed, I'm not subscribed to NerdCubed on that second channel, no. But yeah, I use Chrome for this account because it's my main account, that's my main browser, that's the one I like the most. You can say what you want about all these other... you know, whatever it is, but I don't care, I like Chrome. Then I think TRE playthroughs is logged into on Firefox. Actually, the Bagel Club. I think the Bagel Club and TRE playthroughs sort of switch between each of them because I don't use either. So there's still a bunch of videos I need to upload to TRE playthroughs, actually. Not gonna lie, but I'll get them sorted at some point. Not for me. I have two emails set up. But I mean, like, the both on Chrome. Yeah, I don't know. It's just the way I like to work things better. Again, I like to sort of have one thing on one channel. I don't, unless I'm doing other, like, personal stuff, then there's no reason for me to log out of this channel. Yes, the Bagel Club channel. I am still logged into it. We're still working on doing something with it. I think Rhino and Mule are recording a thing today. I would assume that's only gone on his main channel because he hasn't got anyone else in it. It's just Rhino and Mule. Don't watch it. It'll be rubbish, Kappa. But yeah. Yeah, definite Kappa. I don't know. But yeah, I don't know if... like I said, I'm fairly certain that I'll just go on Rhino's channel. Almost 100% certain, actually. Please add account. Press add account. Yeah, I know you could do that, but I don't care enough to do that. So, because my issue with that is I've tried that before, and basically it'll just log into whatever account you have. Sort of briefly termed. If I go on, like, Chrome... if I go onto Google search, like, it'll sign out of the account that I added and sign back into the sort of the main one, if you will, and I don't like it when it does that, so if I need to sign out for whatever reason, I will sign out on Chrome. I'll just re-add the account, because it's not hard to put password and an email address back in, so, and do the do the phone thing as well, like you need to do now, so. Now it works. Does it? Again, I still don't care enough to really investigate it, to be honest with you. Oh, God, on the brakes. I should have been on the brakes a little bit sooner, because I'm going to cream towards the sand. There we go. Please don't... Jesus, no. I'm not speaking about that. I spoke about it on Thunder's podcast. I said all of the nice things I had to say about Pokemon Go on Thunder's podcast. I'm not saying anything more on it. YouTube won't send some words. Oh, it does that occasionally. I think it's just when people have bad internet occasionally when I'm chatting. Like, huh? Won't send some... r/bagel? Apparently he's saying it now, I don't know. God, I don't think the Bagel Club will ever have a Reddit. I'm fairly certain it won't, just because it's... You know, I don't think any of us use Reddit for any reason. I'm fairly certain we don't, anyways. It was kind of cool, though. Some guy, you're in a podcast. I was in, I'm not actually in a podcast full time because it's, we switch the hosts out all the time. But if you go to Funder's channel, it is HD Talk episode 3. I was in that. Yeah, I'm not a full time host or anything. As much as I would love to be, I think they just sort of do a first come, first serve. And yeah, I don't know. I'll see how Funder arranges the next one. Kidding. Well, it's 2 hours long, so I'd recommend watching that while you go to sleep or something, probably. r/bagels a porn subreddit? Oh. Anyways. But yeah, some guy on Twitter, I think he's one of Rhino's friends. I'm not sure, though. He was actually playing a wrestling game, and he made a shirt for us, which was goddamn awesome. He made, like, an official Bagel Club shirt. It was pretty sick. Speaking of that, actually, I don't know as a wrestling fan here, but I do just want to say that on... I'm fairly certain it's the 16th of August they're making it a free game, but 2K16 is... Or it could be 2K15. I swear it's 16, though. 2K16, I believe, is listed as one of the games for gold for next month. So, one of my streams in August will, in all likelihood, be a 2K16 stream. Just because I figured that would be a fun game to play on stream. Even if you don't like wrestling, I still recommend checking that one out, because, of course, you're on a porn subreddit, clearly. Anyways, I do recommend checking that one out, even if you don't like wrestling, because it'll be fun. We'll beat some people up and make our way through the ranks and stuff. That should be pretty sweet. I don't know. Again, I'm still playing. I don't know. I kind of want to do my 24-hour stream in August as well, but we'll have to see about that one now, because I'm not really sure. But yeah, hopefully I can. Hopefully my internet will last long enough to survive a 24-hour stream. I don't know if it will. I doubt it, but it's all part of this feeling out game, you know? It's all part of this, you know, whatever. I don't know. Anyways. Lap 6 of 8. 6 of 8, 6 of 8, 6 of 8. Bow down to the... Bow down to the bagel. I don't know. Anyways. It's not porn anymore. I'm not subscribed to it. So is it actually about bagels at this point? We were searching the Bagel Club hashtag not long ago. WWE 2K16 is unrealistic. It's not fake. Clearly. Again, wrestling isn't fake. It's predetermined. You bastard. Anyways. Yeah, 2K16, like, some of the moves on that game look fucking brutal. It's great. You can, I'm fairly certain in 2K16 you can probably, like, physically actually murder people in that game, because just some of the moves are horrendous. Do you even know what my Reddit name is? Boost and Ethanol? Boost and Bethanol, I don't know. It's what you're shipping. Is that what the kids call it? Ship? I don't know. Is that when you like put two names together? Fucking I don't know. Anyways. Yeah, I don't know. Hopefully I do want to go ahead and actually get into the whole podcasting thing. Daniel, you're fake. Movies are fake. This game is fake. The 370Z is fake. No, it's not. Still. It's my old channel's name. And porn and bagels. And anyways, I would actually kind of like to get on the whole podcasting wheel again. The issue is I don't want to. It's such a weird one because, like, I do think HG Talk, when we did it, worked really fucking well, and I know Rhino, basically everyone who was there at the time, really enjoyed having it, and to be honest with you, I think Thunder said that was the best episode they've ever done. So, I don't know. The problem is, if he doesn't switch people out constantly, people will say, oh, it's unfair because I should be in it because it's HG Talk, but I don't know. It would be kind of cool to have certain guests constant. Well, I guess Rhino's sort of a constant feature. But we'll have to see. It really depends who's on the podcast as well, because if it's just a bunch of people that I don't know, I'll say, you know, people who I don't know too well, it's probably best that we sort of avoid, or I avoid doing those people. We could podcast, I mean, we could. Actually, to be fair, you actually seem like a reasonable person who knows his knowledge, so. Yeah, maybe, I don't know. It's all one of my plans for the future. Again, I've got to work out how to fucking record it and all the rest of it, which is going to be an absolute the grind happy and ethanol racing gear. Clearly. Oh yeah, you did put grind in there. I was going to say, where's the MC grinder, but he's in there. Anyways, yeah. So, I don't know, that's just sort of a thing I'd like to get a lot more into, because I really like doing the podcast. I think it went really fucking well. I do think the pacing in some places could have been improved. Certain questions people dragged on for a bit too long, but other than that, it went really fucking well, so. Yeah, I don't know. It's kind of cool. But again, if it's for people I don't know too well, it probably won't turn out quite as well, so. Eh, I don't know. Oh, I will say, Ethanol, the HG Talk was a little bit wrestling orientated, so if you don't like the wrestling, You can probably skip through most of that. Oh yeah, like I said, there's a few pacing bits which could have probably been a little bit better, but other than that, I really enjoyed it. And hey, the car behind is 12 seconds behind, and I'm across the line, which means we are done with the F430 challenge. 57,536 credits, nothing new. Race 2 came 8th, controller disconnection issue. Oh, can you record audio? I'll have to figure it out. Hey, Ross is here. Anyways, we finished first in the Ferrari F430 challenge. We've been awarded in an F430 race car. You get 85,000 credits for finishing the F430 challenge, and there's our race car. Pretty cool looking race car, I guess. I don't know, it's alright. Anyways, that is it for this episode of the Forza Motorsport 2 Let's Play. So, in the next episode, we're going to be heading back into the regional championships to finish the final regional championship, which is going to be the Pan-European Championship. So, join me for that. Anyways, friends, I want to thank you all very much for watching. My name has been The Real Emil, and until next time, farewell.